welcome to Behind the Stunts. I'm John Orty. Thanks very much indeed for checking in with me again this week. And a packed show, so let's crack straight on with Wolverine, firstly, which is the latest installment, the X-Men spin-offs. Hugh Jackman, of course, as the Wolverine, allowing every beard wearer in the world to be happy once again, knowing that there's a lead character superhero out there with more facial hair than I have. It was always going to be a big success, this movie. The success of the X-Men pictures was almost guaranteed because of the product itself. It's a very, very solid product, and they've done some... Wolverine was always going to be the spin-off, wasn't it, really? Some terrific action here, lots of green screen stuff, lots of wire work, lots of great fights. Kyle Gardner is our stunt coordinator, along with Alan Poppleton, the two guys responsible for the action. Good fights. I mentioned that fight choreographers Jonathan Estivo and John Valera are the two that share that particular responsibility, and they are ably assisted by Brett Sherrin. It's interesting to point out that the second unit director is David Leitch, who in the past has, as a stuntman, clocked up a whole bunch of credits with 300, V for Vendetta, and of course Fight Club. So there was never going to be short of action. Hugh Jackman is perfectly capable of selling every single action sequence here, and here's the trailer to get you a better feel. Run!
Beautiful, Yoshida. Keep it safe for me. Someday I'll come get it.
My employer is dying. He wants to thank you for saving his life all those years ago. It's an honor to meet the Wolverine.
That's not who I am anymore.
After the war, the Yoshida family business became Japan's largest. He made advances that have saved millions of lives.
I want to offer you a gift, Logan.
You have struggled long enough.
Your ability to heal can be passed
to another. Allow someone else to shoulder your burden.
Logan-san, I can make you mortal.
Trust me, Bob.
You don't want what I've got.
I'm not ready to die.
Bleeding.
Just keep moving.
I'm not healing. She did this to me.
This flesh is weak now.
Hey, Bob.
What are you?
A chemist, a capitalist, a viper.
So you can see the future.
I saw you die.
We will accept your surrender with respect.
Is that all the men you brought?
Your grandfather called me a Ronin. Samurai without a master. Who has no reason to live.
Was he right?
Yeah. 3D and large format theaters. Rated PG-13.
There we go. That's Wolverine doing what Wolverine does best. Apart from getting his nails clipped. I need to get that sorted. A manicure. French. Maybe a French manicure. Who knows where it'll end next time. That is out on the 24th. Once again, due to broadband issues and various other bits and pieces, if you are watching this episode and it's after the 24th, then you'll have beaten me to it, but I apologise for that, it's technology for you. Our stunt reel feature for this particular issue, it's a guy who, when you look at the amount of work that he's done through the 70s, the 80s, the 90s, an astonishing array of action. The sequences that you're going to see here, you've got, what have you got? You've got Hunter, you've got Airwolf, you've got Street Hawk, you've got Knight Rider. I mean, there's all manner of television shows involving action, involving cars, television, movies. There's no end of movies involved here. An extraordinary reel of stuff. I'm referring, of course, to Bob Bralver, who really does clock up some mileage on this particular reel. And it's a joy to watch. And also, importantly, every single gag you're going to look at here. No CGI, nothing at all. This is way before the days of CGI in that respect. So take a look at this and enjoy. This is Bob Bralver.
We'll be right back.
just astonishing. I mean, the jaw wide open looking at the amount of stuff that Bob has done. And there's lots of stuff on there that I've seen for years and gone, oh, I didn't realise that was him, you know. So just wonderful stuff. Bob Bralver, a terrific stunt reel. Now we're going to look at our classic sequence for this particular week. And this reverts back to a Disney movie from 1980. It's called Watcher in the Woods and was a movie that starred Betty Davis, in her later years. The sequence that we're looking at revolves around horses, is the initial part. So there is a young girl on a horse. The horse gets spooked by the watcher in this instance, but you'll need to see the movie to understand that, but the sequence doesn't lose anything from it. So the horse gets spooked. A guy on the horse goes after her to try and prevent her horse from ultimately jumping a fence into a main road where there is a truck, an oncoming truck, and this is what happens.
Let's go back through the woods.
No, Mike. I don't think we should.
Oh, come on.
Sadly, no longer with us. Roy driving the truck and up the ramp and rolls it over and gets it into the road there. Stunt supervisor on that particular picture, I think it's worthwhile mentioning because that was his first, to my knowledge, stunt coordinating job. He may have had some others previously, not quite as credited maybe, but his first official job there was a young man called Vic Armstrong. What about that happened to him? Oh well. So yes, Vic was responsible for that. Of course, he'd done Escape to Athena before that, but I mean they were released around the same sort of time. But yes, Vic Armstrong and Roy Alon, a great team, and they worked with each other on numerous occasions throughout the 70s and 80s and 90s. So there we go. That's our sequence for this particular week. Next time around, we will have The Heat, Sandra Bullock, in the comedy. And our stunt reel will be from Sophia Crawford, who I only have to say Buffy the Vampire Slayer, and all of you get excited. So we'll do that next time around. And until then, stay safe, and thank you very much indeed for watching. And I'll catch up with you very soon. All the best. Bye-bye.